Hello, good morning one and all. Today we are gathered to learn about structure in C language. This is Dr. Abhijit C. Jadeja from BP College of Computer Studies, Vodabhai Patel College of Computer Studies, BCA, Kadisar Vishwavidyalay, Gandhinagar. So let me start the discussion about structure in C language. First of all, we need to understand the need of structure, why we use the structure and what is the problem that we need to utilize the structure. The problem is how to group together a collection of data items of a different data types that are logically related to a particular entity. The basic things that we learn that was array. But my friends, array, you know, it is a collection of different values having same data type. But I would like to repeat the problem, how to group together a collection of data items that is having a different data types. So array is a solution for different data types? The answer is no, no, and no. So what is the solution? The solution is structure. So I think you compare array with structure within this concept. You understand structure may be a collection of different data type and array is a collection of similar data type. The next, structure. Structure is a collection of variables of different data types under a single name, as we previously discussed it. That is collection of variable having a different data types. The variable are called member variable of structure, and structure is also called a user defined data type. Yes, my dear friends, that is very important. Structure always defined by a developer as per his or her need. So it is a user defined data type. And the member variable that is declared under the structure is known as member variable. If we are taking the real life example, in one company there are various departments and it is an example of structure. If we want to making a data type about one XYZ company and it has a various department like production, store, human resource, marketing, so many departments. So if we want to gather this all department by a C program concept, that we use a user defined data type, that is called structure. The next, block diagram of structure. As your screen and my cursor is moving, struct keyword we are using, structure name we should give as a parenthesis or curly bracket is there. Data type member variable 1, data type member variable 2, dash dash dash, data type member variable n, and this parenthesis or curly bracket is over, then semicolon is there. Once structure name is declared as new data type, then variable of that type can be declared as structure name and structure variable. This is furtherly known as leading variable. So again I would like to repeat so you people will not confuse. Struct keyword is used to declare the structure. This is a structure name. Structure member variables that is having a different data types. Once structure name is declared, but leading variable is declared afterwards. Very important notes for all of us is the members of structure do not occupy any memory unit. They are associated with structure variable or this leading variable. So if we declare here 10 variables and 10 variables are having a different data type, but when we are assigning within a leading variable by dot operator, at that time only, at runtime only, it occupy memory. So always be remember, structure is more efficient. Structure is more useful than traditional variable because it uses the memory when we utilize structure member variable within a leading variable. Let me take an example about your real life only. Struct is a keyword, student is a name of a structure. Character data type, the name should be having a 20 characters, integer roll number, float marks, character gender, M for male, F for female, long integer for phone number. So you can understand here various type of data types are there. It is a string, it is a integer, it is a float, it is a single character, and this is long integer for phone number more than 8 digit or 10 digit. Struct student, this is a structure name, and yes, st is my leading variable. So you can declare the st, that is very important, because st is a leading variable that can access name, roll number, marks, gender, and phone number also. So later on we will announce this thing as a leading variable. Multiple variable of a structure student type can be declared as, yes, my dear friends, if st1.name, st1.rollNumber, st1.marks, st1.gender, st1.phoneNumber, it is just for one student. If we want to take three students' data, then we declare st1, st2, st3, along with a struct keyword. Student is a structure name. So I think you people will understand the example of student, your real life example only, and various data types are there. So it is very clear to understand. It is a different concept than array, and it is much more utilizing and power of memory management in structure. If we want to define the structure, each variable of structure has its own copy of member variables. The member variables are accessed using the dot operator or a leading variable within a leading variable. For example, st1.name is a member variable name, st of st1 is a structure variable, while st3, student3 gender, is a member variable of gender, and st3 is a structure variable. If we want to classify this, both the things, whatever that is mentioned within a dot, where my cursor is moving, kindly observe. Here it is a description is given, where st1 or st3 are known as leading variable. A variable that can lead to access the data, data in and data out, so it is known as leading variable. Dot name and dot gender are known as member variables. Here you can go within a previous slide. Gender is a member variable, name is a member variable, but st1, st2 and st3 known as leading variable. So structure is a different data type, collection of a different data type under the one common name, and it has two things, member variable and leading variable. Let me move ahead. Defining a structure, if we want to declare a structure, there are two types of that, and it is on your screen. The structure definition and variable declaration can be declared as struct, student, curly bracket, as we discussed the previous variables are as it is, and into the bracket st1, st2, st3, these are the semicolon that we are giving. This is the most efficient declaration that we are utilize this thing. Another declaration is also used with the struct student space st1, st2 and st3, that is mentioned over here. So again, I would like to repeat, struct student, and the letter on st1, st2 and st3 is given. So I think this is the best declaration part on your screen. Structure initialization. Yes, first we need to understand why we should give a prefix value to the structure and how we can declare it. Struct, structure name, structure variable or leading variable equal to value 1, value 2 or value n. There is a one-to-one correspondence between member variables. There are the initialization does not initialize the individual structure member within a structure definition template. Means when structure declare leading variables is declared, at that time equal to curly bracket, and we can initialize the each value. The next slide we can understand. Yes, this is the real example of C language program. So concentrate, my dear students and friend. Void main, and before void main, we declare the structure. Struct student. Student is a name of aliens or structure name. There is a various data type: string, roll number integer, marks is in float, single character gender M for male, F for female, long integer phone is there, void main is there, and now it is the prefix or constant value declaration of structure. Please kindly concentrate, my dear friends. Struct student is a name of structure. St1 is a leading variable, and here one by one we are giving the initialization or constant value. Name is ABC, roll number is 4, the marks is in float, so 79.5, gender is in a single character, so we are using single inverted comma, M for male, F for female, and the phone number is 5010670, long integer range is always more than 38,000 or something like that, so we are mentioning that long integer, and on your screen this is called initialization or constant value we are providing to my member variables. By default, ABC is a name, 4 is a roll number, 79.5 is a marks, M male is a single character, and this is a phone number. CLRSCR, screen clear, printf, a normal output statement, name / t, roll number / t, marks / t, gender and phone number. This is a formatting purpose, so dotted line is given, and after dotted line we would like to print this value, so printf percentage s / t as it is, percentage d for roll number, percentage f for marks, percentage c for a character, percentage long integer, so percentage ld is there. And yes, please kindly concentrate, because this is a practical concept. St1 leading variable dot name, it will access ABC, and ABC will assign to percentage s. St dot roll number, it will access 4, and 4 will be assigned to this percentage d. St1 dot marks, then 79.5 will access, and that 79.5 will be accessed to percentage f. St1 dot gender means that will carried out or access m, single m, and that will be assigned to percentage c. Finally, 5010670, this is a phone number, and it will be assigned to long integer ld. Get ch, and the program is completed within a structure initialization or structure by default constant value. Let me move ahead, my dear friends. The question or the exercise: create a structure name student that has name, roll number and marks as a member variable. Assume appropriate type and size of a member variable. Write a program of using a structure to read and display the data entered by the user. In this exercise, read and data entered by the user, that is main concept. So this is a self exercise for all of you in this part and this time. So let me understand how we can construct the program of read and how can we enter the data by the user. The program is on your screen. Struct keyword, student is a name, as we mentioned, character name, integer roll number, float marks, semicolon is given. Void main, main program started now. Structure is generally defined before void main. Upper size of a void main, curly bracket start, struct student, this is the same of structure student, and s is a leading variable that can access this member variable. So s, I am giving this thing, clrscr, printf, enter the name of student, get string s dot name, this s will get the name and it will assign to this name 20. Printf, enter roll number, percentage d, so this is string and we are using get, so we do not require and this operator or and person, Here we use n person s dot roll number. Roll number will scanf take by user, or we will enter, we are taking by user, or user will enter the roll number, and roll number will assign to this member variable name roll. Enter marks, and this is percentage f, float data type. Address operator we use as a leading variable, s dot marks, that marks whatever the user enter, for example 84.89 or 97.23, this marks will assign to this marks. Enter roll number, marks, and this is a formatting with backslash n and percentage t. I am using just for formatting purpose. Printf, this is dotted line, this is a formatting line that will be making underline of it. Percentage s, backslash t, percentage d, percentage f. Sequentially, s dot name, name whatever we are enter, it will display here. S dot roll, that is leading variable and member variable. Whatever roll number we entered, that will be displayed by percentage d here. S dot marks, it's a float data type. S leading variable, marks is a member variable. Whatever the marks, suppose 97.23 or 87.44, that will be displayed by percentage f, get ch, and program is over. So I think this exercise you understand how we can take the data from the user at runtime within dot operator that we previously discussed in a structure within a member variable and leading variable. Move ahead. Structure variable, two variable of a structure, the same structure can be defined as a copy within a same ordinary variable. Suppose if we are using structure name student1 and structure name student2 belong to the same structure, then the following statement are valid for this. Suppose we declare one structure, the name is student1, and later on we declare the structure name student2. So student1 equal to student2 and student2 equal to student1. However, the statement such as, if we want to use the structure1 is equal to student2, and if we want to use double equal to, and student1 does not, means exclamation sign and equal to, you know that one, comparison operator, less than, greater than, less than and equal to, greater than and equal to and not equal to, are not permitted here. Double inverted, double equal to sign will not valid, and not equal to sign will not valid for structure or assigning the copy of it. If we need to compare the structure variables, we may do so by comparing member variables individual. So if we want to make a copy of student 2 structure to student 1, that is possible by this declaration. My cursor is moving. If we want to make a student 1 copy to student 2, that is valid, but this two statement where I am using double equal to and not equal to, not valid. Here the structure has been declared globally outside of main function. Now any function can be accessed and it can create the structure variable also, character student. Only two member variables are there, name of student and roll number integer, void main, structure student 1. And we are initialized, ABC is a name that will be assigned to name, and 4 is a roll number that will assign to roll. Struct keyword student name and student 2 I am giving. Now CLR is here. Student 2, student 1 is having a data and student 2 does not having a data. So student 2 equal to student 1, it means whatever the data we are assigning this name to ABC, or ABC will assign to name, 4 roll number will assign to roll number. Now all this member variable will be assigned to student 2 also. This is a proof of this program. You can check in your Turbo C compiler also, or online compilers are available to check this program. Printf, student 2 dot name equal to percentage s and student 2 dot name. Here my friends, ABC will print by student 2 because we copied student 1 data, whole member variable data, to student 2. Student 2 roll number equal to percentage t, student 2 dot roll number. And if we want to make a whole structure copy and comparison, we use string comparison of strcmp, that function known as string comparison. My cursor is moving. Kindly observe this thing very properly, my dear students and friend. If strcmp into the bracket student1.name comma student2.name equal to 0. Same like that, student1.role and student2.role, if we are that both are same, student1 and student2 are same because we copied everything by this statement where my cursor is moving, my dear students and friend. Student2 equal to student1, so student1 data will completely copied to student2, and this is a proof because this condition will true by string comparison. Get CH and program is over. Kindly check this program in your Turbo CE software or online compiler. Thank you so much, and we are moving to towards ahead for a structure, array of structure. Let us consider we have a structure that as it is we had discussed since last several minutes of this online lecture. Structure student, character name, roll number, character remarks, and float marks are there. If we want to keep a record of 100 students, we have to make 100 structure variable like st1, st2, like st100. It is really very tedious and very boring because we cannot declare individual variable more than 3, because previously we understand st1, st2 and st3, student 1, student 2 and student 3. But if we have a confusion and logical problem of 100 student, is it so? In this situation we can use array of structure to store the records of 100 students, which is easier and efficient to handle because loop can be used for 100 student also. This is a mega concept that we must learn, because if in a company there is a department named production, and in a production, in a manufacturing, more than 1000 employees are working at the same time, we can use the same things because 1000 data in a C language manage and organize by structure only within a different data type. My dear friends, array could not do this. Array has its own limitation where structure is more powerful. Yes, array of structure, and how we can declare array of structure. This is the best example on my right side and left side. Struct student into the member variable, as you know, character name, integer roll number, remarks within a character, float is a marks, bracket over st 100. This is a direct leading variable st that is assigned by student. Student is a structure name, and that 100 student data can be managed by this. If we declare like this, struct student, all the member variables is clearly seen on your screen. Later on, struct again keyword, student again structure name, and st is a leading variable. So I think this is more easy for all of us. Let me move ahead. How we can take a data from the user when structure is executed and program is running. So as we know that one previously we discussed by loop, and this is for loop. This is the only logic that I am sharing with you. Later on the program can be program will be discussed in this video only, online lecture only. For I equal to 0 semicolon, I less than 5, so the 5 students data will be used. I plus plus, printf, enter roll number, s of I means 0 students roll number, 0 students name, and 0 students last name means 0 1 2 3 4. This loop will continue for 5 times, and 5 students roll number, first name and last name will be managed and addressed by array of structure. Here structure is a leading variable s, and I consistently or continuously s of 0 first, s of 1 same like s of 4 for fourth variable. So I think you people will understand how we can enter the data into the structure, array of structure. If we want to sort the value, this is a bubble sort that you know very well. We are using two loop and I, j, j equal to I plus 1 means whatever the I value is that plus of 1, that is I of 0 is then this particular j is starting with 1. So this internal loop will be managed by a sorting method that you know very well. If s of I means s of 0 is less than and equal to s of j means your next roll number, this sorting will be performed. The smallest value will come to the temporary variable. The largest value will come to that zero index, zero position, and the largest value is again use the temporary variable. This sorting technique you learn in the previous lecture or in your fundamental class. So this is the sorting of value in structure. So we can see that one, roll number manage by sorting method. If we enter the roll number randomly, suppose we enter 75 roll number, then after I entered 8 roll number, then after I entered 22, and then after I entered 1. So it should be a sequence like 1, 18, 25, and 78. So it should be sort by this particular bubble sort method. I think you can understand by this sorting method. Two loops are there and comparison. Home exercise and homework for this structure is define a structure of employee having a data member. Member of data is name, string, address, string, age, integer, and salary. Long integer, you can take the data for an employee. So this is again an array of structure in array and find the average salary. So if we are entering 10 employees data, what is the average salary of this 10 people? That can be making the sum of all the salary, then after divide how many employees data you enter. Suppose you entered 10 employees data, then you divide with 10, and this is a very nice exercise to get the knowledge about array of structure. Member variable on your screen, name, address, age, and salary. Another program within some limitations and very easy for you guys. Write a program to read name, address, and salary. Here age is not there. Of 5 employees, this is a fixed 5 employees data that is giving using array of structure and display information of each employee in alphabetical order of their name. Yes, this is a string comparison of alphabet order of your array. Suppose I entered any employee name, his name is Zakir, then I enter the name of any employee named Yugvir, and then after I entered my name Abhijit. So whenever we want to display the name of alphabetical order, I need to show my name first Abhijit, then as per alphabet Yugvir is there, and last Zakir for Z will come. So here the average salary is a main task for you guys, and here the alphabetical order of a structure, it is a homework exercise for you guys. Array within a structure, so very nice, and it is a I think a very important concept, because sometimes we have faced some complications, and here some complications are that we can use a single or multi-dimension array for type of integer, for float value as well as integer. Structure, student, character name, integer roll number, and yes my friends, float marks. Here we want to enter the 5 subject marks, so we are using float marks. This is a simple string that you are easy to understand, but if we want to make student 1 marks of one subject, student 1 marks of two subject, student 1 marks of three subject, same like up to 5 subject marks, this is called array within a structure. So this problem or this logical solutions we need to carry it out within a title of array within a structure and array of structure. Here struct student s is a leading variable, array of structure is there, and here we want to enter 6 different subject marks. So this is array within a structure. Array within a structure, here the member marks of the content of 6 element or 6 subjects that we already discussed, marks of 0, marks of 1 and marks of 5. So this are the 6 subject marks indicating the marks obtained in a 6 different subjects. This element can be accessed by using appropriate subscript. For example, if I have leading variable s25.marksof3 refers to the marks obtained in a 4th subject by 26 students. My dear friends, you know that one, array always start with the 0 index or 0 location. So 25 indicate 26 students and this 3 indicate 4th subject. So it is easy to understand that 4th subject marks, this is mentioned, my cursor is moving, 4th subject, and 26 students, 26th student details we are entering. If we want to solve this problem within an array within structure and an array of structure, how can we manage? Here, this is a very nice thing is there, and I think this is the best thing that you can practice on your Turbo C or on online compiler also. Here there is n students data, so we are making this loop for I equal to 0, I less than n and I plus plus. Enter the information about the student, name, s, string is there, so we do not require n person. S of I means s of 0, first student name, address of s of I because integer is there, and a class, suppose in grade 7, grade 5, grade 6, so address operator integer is there, so we need address operator s of I and class. Section means division A, division B, division C, so printf, scanf, percentage C, and percentage C is there, so address operator is there. Students, you know that one, percentage as string does not require address operator, but percentage C character single A, B, C, D, in which division he or she is studying, so s of I dot sections. 0 students means first student name, first student class, first student division, and input marks of 6 subjects. So please, may I have concentration? Please, students, understand these things very minorly, very micro level. For j equal to 0, j less than 6, j plus plus, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here the loop will continue for 6 times, 0 to 5. Scanf, a temporary variable will be taking a value from u when scanf is there. S of I marks of j means first student, first marks, whatever you are entered into the temp, it will assign. Same thing, this loop will be moving ahead and j value is 1. Scanf, temp, again your second marks, second subject marks. S of I marks of j means 1, means second subject marks. Continuously, this loop will be continued, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This 6 subject marks will be considered 0 to 5. And one by one, temporary variable will take a data from you and it will assign to the array of structure, array within a structure. This is the last concept that we are understanding with couple of slides, and this is the last concept of pointer of structure. So today we want to finish whole concept of a structure very minor level. So consider this thing very minorly. A structure is a type of pointer, it's a user defined data type, and we can declare as a pointer also. Struct is a keyword, book. Now we are taking an example about book, library, character, book name, integer, pages, and plot is a price. The structure is completed by parenthesis and semicolon, struct book, and we are using pointer variable, my friends, book pointer star bptr. However, this is declaration of a pointer of a structure. and pointed to the structure does not allocate any memory for a structure, but allocate only a pointer. So to access the structure member variable through a pointer, because we know that one pointer can be managed multiple variables, pointer can manage hard drives also, and we know, we already learned in my previous lectures or in my previous video of a pointer, pointer is having its own advantages. So we are using the last and very important concept, BPTR. This is a pointer variable of a structure. Now, if we want to declare the pointer within a star, that is book pointer, and we access this book pointer within member variable, we have a three method of, we have a three method to access the member variable, BPTR, arrow, name. It's a member variable, BPTR, arrow, pages, integer value, number of pages of a book, BPTR, arrow operator, price of a book, or we can using this thing, curly bracket, book pointer as it is, dot name as previously. But my dear friends, I consider this arrow operator because it is more faster, and we can say that when we learn data structure in a future, we need to understand double pointer concept. So I prefer personally this arrow operator when we using pointer as in structure. Here this is called arrow operator, and there must be a pointer to the structure on the left side of this operator. So clearly this is a new operator that you learn when we declare pointer of structure, and this pointer variable accessing name of book, pages of book, and price of book, we use arrow operator. So I think you people will understand pointer to structure or pointer of structure. Along with this, structure, book, star, BPTR, BPTR, malloc function should be utilized, because here we use that one. When pointer use, you, pointer we are using memory using malloc function, memory allocation function. In my previous lecture of the same channel, it is available, the dynamic memory allocation. You can easily understand the concept of memory allocation, malloc function, and calloc function. So malloc function is more utilized. Whenever we need the memory allocation, we use malloc function. Book pointer, malloc, size of struct, book. So the pointer is utilized only those memory cell that we are using. Suppose in a book name, I consider 50 characters, and the book name is very small, like Life of C or Complete Reference of C or Balaguru Swami or any big author or any another author's name is there. The book is Complete Reference of C, let we take it, or C language. This is utilized only 11 to 12 characters. If we use the malloc function, we can save so much memory bytes in our C language. Enter the name, scanf, book pointer, as we already discussed, arrow operator is there, and enter the number of pages, book pointer, address operator is taking because this is an integer variable, percentage as string does not require address operator. So my dear students and friends, book pointer, arrow operator name, book pointer, arrow operator pages, book pointer, arrow operator price, and that is equal to temp, because we can take it that float value into the temp, scanf, and then after we are assigning that temporary value to my book pointer. Pointer to the structure, along with this, it's a very necessary to understand, as we already discussed, that the structure can be declared as a various data type, and if we want to use pointer variable in a structure, but we are using a reference. So pointer of structure, now pointer to structure, struct book, book details, member variable is given, book name, pages, and price, struct book, structure name. B is a leading variable, star BPTR means book pointer, BPTR equal to address of B. In the same channel, in my same channel, pointer of C language, I already discussed the advantages of it. So always pointer accept the address value of another variable, and another variable is nothing but it is a leading variable of my structure. My dear friends, so this is pointer to the structure. Again, we declare a book structure, book name, book pages, book price. The leading variable is B. Along with this, I would like to utilize book pointer star BPTR and star BPTR use the reference, the address of B. Here the base address of B is assigned to BPTR pointer. If we use BPTR or B, how can we use this data? Now there is a tree structure. This is the last concept that you need to understand, because this is the concept somewhat complex, because we are utilizing not direct pointer, but we are using the reference pointer, because my structure B give the reference or the address to my book pointer. Understand? Now member of this structure book can be accessed by three ways. If we use B as it is, then B.name, B.page, B.price. It's a normal structure program that today we already discussed before some slides ago. It's a normal program. There is no pointer we use. But if we use book pointer pointer, BPTR arrow name for book name, BPTR arrow operator pages for book pointer for the pages of a book, and BPTR price arrow operator I am using, so book pointer is there, and that is a normal that we already discussed in a previous slide. But my dear friends, I prefer the central level process where I use arrow operator, because again I would like to repeat, when you people will learn data structure, at that time linked list, stack, queue, this concept use double pointer, and double pointer is somewhat explained and understand by this arrow operator. So I prefer personally, if we use pointer of structure, BPTR arrow name, BPTR arrow pages, BPTR price, this is nothing, it's a simple structure, this is a pointer structure, and this is another a declaration of it. So along with this, we are completing the pointer of structure. Thank you one and all. If you like this channel, if you like to learn somewhat concept about anything VB.NET, ASP.NET, JavaScript, C language, somewhat electronic circuits, and so many videos are available within this channel, please, please, please kindly subscribe my channel and share my channel. Thank you so much one and all. If you have any doubt about structure of C that today's lecture we are discussing, kindly put your questions, kindly arise your question in a comment box. I will surely try my level best to satisfy your queries, your questions, your confusions, whatever you are typed in a comment. Thank you so much all of you. Here again, Dr. Abhijit Singh Jadeja with you on learning series, work from home, BP College of Computer Studies, Kadisar Vishwavidyalay. Today we learn the concept of structure in C, user defined data type, and that is more powerful. We completed structure, need of structure, simple structure, get data from the user by the structure. We understand array of structure, array within a structure, pointer of structure, and pointer reference variable structure. If you have any doubts and queries, you can rewind this video, replay this video, kindly share and subscribe. Thank you so much. Have a nice day. Have a nice time. Thanks a lot.